everybody, welcome back. So I got all moved in. I'll go show you real quick. As you can see, all of that down there is gone. And it's now up here. I put a single block of water there just so I could refill my canteen. And I've been spawning cakes in with my staff. So over here we've got various loops, mob drops, plants, tools and armors, farming stuff, and magic stuff, wood logs and wood. Wait, those ones up there. Various machine parts, various blocks, crafted stuff, empty. This will be build craft stuff. Machines from IC2, fuels, ingots, gems, foods, raw foods, and cooked. Then I also, we have this, which will be the tasks for today. I made another one. I really like them, and I blocked that off because I was getting mobs. It's not completely secure up there yet. I just put my bed there, and then I put these here, my power, and that runs down to here. So the first task for today that we're going to do is actually the last one on the list. We're going to make a door. But we're not going to just make any door. We're going to make a fancy door from one of the new mods, which we're going to do a iron glass door. Right. And we have one more thing we need to do with that. So hold on. So 1, 2, 3. I also cooked up a bunch of materials, as you can see. And I also want to make 2 player sensors. So that's 6 of those. 4 of those. 2 of those. Let's see if you can shift click these in. You can. Okay. So these are, I'm pretty sure these are player sensors. Will only scan players. So if I put it there and there. Watch this. So, isn't that amazing? Of course, this isn't the final door, but this will just keep us safe for now, right? So, because I was getting mobs coming in there, so then I need to make some Jabba barrels. Wait, I want to put this torch. We'll put it there. And I also took the opportunity to get a bunch of, just still getting used to it, wood, so let's get out some wood. I need 6 of them. And that's 6 chests. Actually, I can do, we are going to need some of these though. 4. I know I'm making way more than I need for that, but that's alright. Shift click. I'm not sure what I'm going to put in all 6 of them. That just happens to be exactly how many spots I have laid out for them. Then let's put, then I'm going to put slabs in too. Let's put those away. Alright, and those are mainly for cobblestone and limestone. Of course, I'll move all, that's all that's left up here is cobblestone and limestone. I'll move all that in off camera. But, so that's another check off the list. So, barrels. Now I want to automate my macerator and my furnace. Now, that's where we're getting a little bit complicated. So we're going to need, I'm not going to automate the input on the macerator though. A redstone, this engine. I think I'm going to need 3 of them. So I know that for that I'm going to need a decent amount of wood, and let's see, what else are those? Pistons, that's glass, iron, I have 1 piston here, redstone. I'm also going to need some levers to power them. And if we're going to do 3, we might as well get 3 levers. I know I have some 6 left, not many. Okay. So, Oh, I forgot I had those. Okay, that's okay. Let's get some wood. So, I know each one is made out of gears. So, let's make those. 6 gears. Bam. That gives us a chief. Cool. Alright, and we're gonna need another piston. Oh, I'm gonna have to make the levers again, because that's not right, is it? I'm gonna have to go get some more cob anyways. Maybe I should just grab the stack. Who knows what else we'll need it for. I do really like my base. I am so pleased with it. I know it's gonna need a lot of decorations, but besides that, I think I did a good job on it. So, 2 pistons, glass. Oh, actually, I was making 3 of these, wasn't I? That's okay. So let's clear this, and let's make another piston real quick. That's not right, is it? Alright, so then we also will need wooden pipes. Very nice. And just for the sake of, I have a bunch of gold, I'm going to use gold pipes to transport with. Just because, like I said, I have a bunch of gold, and otherwise I'd use cobble and stone and for stuff in the back, but some of these are going to be visible. So we might as well make them look good, you know? So let's get my levers. I might as well make extra. There we go. Alright, let's go see what we can do. Oh, we should probably take with us this and this. And I am going to need chests, so there we go. With plugs, you could do a much smaller, and eventually we will. More side-by-side version of this. The power's right there, by the way. But we don't have plugs, so basically, what we're going to do is, I think this will work. This will be our input chest, and I think, wait a second, is that a, yeah, that's a slab. I had this set up one way, just because I needed to cook a bunch of stuff, but it didn't work. It would have been too big, so I didn't have any of the parts, I just had the chest up there. So basically, what we're gonna do is, that will pipe out into the macerator, and then the macerator will pipe out into the furnace, and then the furnace will pipe out into the output chest. What do you think? That all looks pretty good. Then all we have to do is get some stuff back there, so let's just dig our way back. Oh, man. I thought I had gotten rid of all of that in the wall. Oh, it was just one spot. Okay. Alright, so first of all, let's get some power up to these bad boys. I'm gonna run the power. Oh, I didn't bring any power cables, did I? That's alright. This is what I mean by how convenient having these connected like this are. That's so convenient. So, there they are. I don't know if that's going to be enough, but it might be. So, it's because the power comes in literally right there. So, if I run this like that, that's powered. And then if I run this, I'm going to power this one from the back, because then the power cable won't be visible. Now we need this. Is that gonna, yep. And then this. And then that's not right. And this chest is temporary because I'm going to be piping the stuff back down. And that, now we can realize something. Hold on. Oh, because that was a mistake. I should have blocked this off first. Wait, what's in the way there? Oh. What do you think? I think that looks pretty good. And we can test it out. Let's just put that in. Down it goes. Now, there is one problem with this, is it is capable of overflowing. But there is actually a simple fix for that, and maybe we should put the fix in right away. So the fix for that is that. So that if it is to overflow, instead it just loops back around into the chest. Oh, look, there it is. Must have missed it going in. Alright. So then, next, we want to take this. Actually, do you think we should move over one or just allow that cable to be visible? Or neither. There we go. So, not that one. Because we don't have any plugs or nothing. I'm hitting more of this. Some of this is gonna have to go like. Hold on, I'm not going to be. I actually have a shovel. So now, which chest is it? This one, so. Right there, right? Let's refill in all of that. Oh wait, I think I just filled in my path down too. Oh well, I'll go redig it. Yeah, I did. No, I didn't. So, there we go. You can see the hole back there. Once we can make covers and stuff, facades, which, but that takes obsidian, which I don't have yet. We'll be able to get rid of that, but. There we go. That's a pretty good bit of automation, that is. Now I can just drop my ores in there and right down. That's pretty impressive, I think. I really like that. So let us, we'll mark both of those off. Now, new generators. I want to make furnace generators, and eventually we will be upgrading them to 8x furnace generators. Well, these won't, no, wait. Yeah, these. But for now, let's just make this. It's expensive though, as you can see, but I'm gonna need two of them. And actually, because that's so expensive, let's get some cake. Whoops. Because that's so expensive, let's put some more stuff. So, Let's put these away, so build craft. Ricey 2. And let's get some more iron to cook up. Especially now we have all that nice and automated. That'll be... This'll get it going. Nice. That's cool. Okay. Now, so we're going to need two of these. Two furnaces, which we have already made up, so no point in making new ones. Is that right? I'm doing this wrong. No. Oh, do you hear that? Power just ran out. Why isn't that working? I could have sworn. One of these will be to power the query or miners or whatever. So we put that there. Now the reason I'm gonna go with these is they actually show exactly how much time is left. And they actually output more power so fast that the cable I'm using and the bat box can't keep up, but that's quite all right. The only thing is I seem to have not... Something's wrong with the wires. What did I do? Oh, see, there's one wire missing. But that's okay. Plus, they have a really big internal storage, so it'll act as like, it's like having a second bat box. I wouldn't actually need the bat box, except for, well, I shouldn't, there's no charge area, so that's why I need the bat box. Another really cool thing about this is actually producing RF, but it's being converted straight to EU. I love that. Okay. Now, this other generator is just going to get put away for now. Let's mark this off. New Jennies. And then, I also want to make, a drill. I forgot about that. And actually, I'm going to make two drills, so I have one to use. Because that'll be pretty sweet. Okay, so... I wish it wouldn't storm when I record. Bad storm. So, let's put some of this stuff away. Oh, I can put that right there. Nice. I might need the wood. I don't need this. And... we're going to count this right now as... I should have put EU and RF, but that's basically the idea anyways. Okay. So now let's make a scanner. And we can't make the bigger scanner, so for now we'll just make the basic one. So I know I'm gonna need this and this, and we're gonna have to have prawns. We might need some tin. We'll use up the railcraft tin because... Oh, look! The iron's coming down! Oh, that is awesome. Okay. So... I know I'm kind of easily amused, but it has been so long since I played with these IC2 and Buildcraft that... Because I actually have not played with either IC2 or Buildcraft since I played Feed the Beast 1.4.7. And then before that was the old Tekkit pack, because I've been using the new extra utility stuff all the time, and yeah. So I just am severely impressed with it, and well, severely happy to be playing it again, because I think back then is when I had the most fun playing Minecraft. I know I made it. Rubber I have enough of, because I have not planted new rubber saplings. Then I need to hammer two of these. The mini-map flashes every time the light goes off. That's pretty sweet. Alright, Alright, so that's that. And we're gonna... So, oh, I need three more. Wait, I might have... No, I have one. That means that I only need to do one. That's not right. Okay. Then we have to make this, which needs bronze casings and two more of those. Should have some. Yes, nice. Sulfur and lead. I don't think I've picked up any lead, so. Lead. I have lead, though. So we're going to replace this with that. And then when I put that back, you'll see how the overflow works. See, it can't go down, so it will go up. If the overflow wasn't there, then. Oh, it switched to being able to go down. Aw, man. Hold on. I had to pulverize up the lead anyways. Oh, I caught it. Perfect. So say the overflow wasn't there. See, it just shoots out. And I missed that, because that means you have to be very smart with your pipes. You have to have overflows and stuff. And that lead... Whoops, that lead must have went down. Oh no. Oh no. It's gonna get reprocessed. Aha. Boogers. Must be right there. Yeah, I was supposed to catch it as it dust. That is the one problem with these. Eventually we'll have a set of machines that are not automated. And a set that are... Battery. Nice. That should... Nope. I need two gold. Sometimes that just doesn't work. Good thing I found that glowstone in the village, isn't it? Alright, so there's the scanner. So that's going to be the end of this episode. Next episode we will make, and we'll be able to test, the miner. Which will be pretty cool. So, I'm going to say goodbye now, and I'll see you later. You'll probably see me tomorrow. Ciao!